Attention hotline fans, man. We've been talking about this all day long. You know about the recent arrival of a couple of major wrestling superstars on the scene here at World Championship Wrestling. But alas, are there more on the way? And if so, could they be showing up tomorrow night during the bash at the beach? We're going to find out. Plus, WCW says goodbye to some of its great stars. I can't mention any of these superstars' names on the air, but I can and I do give you all of the scoops, all of the inside information, all night tonight, right on up until midnight, on the hotline. Pick up the phone right now. Call 1-900-909-9900. That's 1-900-909-9900.
Fans, after Diamond Dallas Page shocked the world and pinned the Macho Man on Monday, later in the same telecast, Randy Savage brutally attacked Nick Patrick. We're going to hear from the referee, but first, here's what happened. We have
look
a fight.
This.
A cameraman has been.
Dead,
huh? Who is that? That's the Macho Man. That's Nick Patrick.
Get out of here.
Randy Savage has attacked Nick Patrick.
Oh, God!
We may have a broken arm or a busted shoulder or something.
Get him out of here.
We've all heard a picture is worth a thousand words, but I must say, Nick Patrick, we've all saw the pictures of what happened last Monday Nitro with you and Randy Savage, but I think you've got some words that might best detail what did happen in that dressing room.
Well, I'm not able to participate today because of what happened in that dressing room. The man kicked my door open while I was sitting there watching the monitor. He stuck my head in a bucket of water like he was trying to drown me. He punched me out. And then he took coffee and he poured coffee all over me. So now I have burns on my shoulder, my chest, and my stomach. I'm not able to participate today. However, I do understand he's been fined $50,000 for this, which I do appreciate. And I'm not in position to make any demands, but I would like to make a plea to the officials of WCW. We have to have a safe environment. I mean, if you want us to do the right thing, that's what we're trying to do. That's what I've tried to do, and I think that I've proven my loyalty to WCW. You have to back us up and give us a safe environment so that we can do the right thing.
Well, you're talking about a man who lives by his own rules, but also, Nick Patrick, you're pretty much living proof that everybody does deserve a second chance. We've got more action. In fact, let's go up to the ring.
And Dream, I would agree with Nick Patrick right there. I know that there's a lot of skeletons in his closet, but WCW needs to take the steps to ensure that something very bad doesn't happen to a referee. Now, that happened after Diamond Dallas Page appeared in a La Parka mask and pinned the Macho Man Randy Savage. We're going to show the fans later on in this telecast what happened there. Well, here comes La Parka. He was showing the diamond cutter sign right there.
Yeah, it's the real La Parka. Yeah, that's so true. Coming out of the mouth of Nick Patrick, you know, knowing what his past history is. Yeah, everybody deserves a second chance, but bottom line, what came out of that thing, there has to be a governing body that can control this situation. If the NWO, with Hollywood Hulk Hogan and Rodman, defeat the Giant and Luger, let me tell you about chaos at WCW. There will be, because, boys, we'll be down on the bad end of looking up.
You know, I have something I want to say right here about Randy Savage.
Yeah.
And I say this because if he attacks referees, if he burns them with coffee, or if he attacks them and tries to hurt them, who else is he going to attack? Is he going to attack announcers? You know what I'm saying?
I'm listening.
Is he going to attack security officers? Is he going to attack fans? I'm making a call to James J. Dillon right now, and I'm saying publicly.
Are you really?
Yes, I am.
James, I'll be here by myself.
No, I'm saying this right now.
Oh.
James J. Dillon and WCW security should completely ban the Macho Man from coming to an arena again.
That's
and
strong.
They should take the steps, security-wise, out in the front door to physically stop him if he tries to get in.
Get down. That is a strong.
Take him back to Florida and let him sit there the rest of his life and leave us alone.
That's the strongest statement I ever heard you make. There must be something under your burr, a burr under your saddle. You know what I'm talking about? But that is true. Now, whether James J. Dillon can get that done, because I go back. Let's go back. We're talking NWO as we're watching this match here, and the fans can. Let me tell you what. The fans can follow this visually and listen to me vocally.
Let me say this before you go vocally.
What?
What you're seeing here, Lucha Libre rule. Oh, boy. Where anyone can come in at any time.
Yeah.
We're going to see a six-man tag added to Bash at the Beach tomorrow night with the stars you're seeing right now plus more tomorrow night.
After hearing Eric Bischoff throwing a party, 1 year, the anniversary, the wedding, everybody come to the party. What a mega event this pay-per-view is. But Eric Bischoff went on record and said to James J. Dillon, you have no authority, none. You can't do it. So I don't know, for you calling JJ if you're doing any good, I would go higher up. You know what I mean? They got a stadium named after the man that I would talk to.
Let me say this. I'm talking about the authority is what you take on your own.
Right.
The heck with handing out a memo or finding someone, strong arm it. Put people out front and say, all right, come through us now, big guy.
Well, if the Macho Man burns you with coffee, are you just going to brush it off? Or are you going to, after the burn is healed, get a 2x4 and while he's sleeping, exactly, knock him out? Right. Well, that's the bottom line.
All right. And Nick is not refereeing here, as no. Mickey J's the referee, and he's got a mess on his hands.
Yeah, because
these
guys
everywhere.
Yeah, Lucha Libre rules, they can fly. And as you said, these guys here, every time I look at La Parka, I'm thinking about Diamond Dallas Page and that upset victory.
Yes, sir.
Over
and
Rodman. You know, not what, upset for Dallas, but for La Parka, who was really Dallas.
Well, you know, La Parka has been, no question about it, fans who've been following, as Héctor Garza and Psychosis are in now, fans who've been following the sport and following the stars from Mexico, they've been arriving here, know that La Parka has been the most vicious. He has been using a chair repeatedly on opponents after the fact. And now La Parka back in, sending Juventud out to the near side. It has been nothing but really controlled chaos when you see these guys in the ring. Psychosis with a lariat, a lateral press on Garza, Juventud in, and La Parka is going to put him on the shelf, and he's going to follow him out again. This La Parka is a madman.
Yeah, and I'm going to tell you what, when these two guys are outside now, they're not legal. Is that true?
Well, you know, I'm going to be honest with you.
Yes, you don't know.
Sometimes I don't know.
I know, but.
In Lucha Libre rules.
Okay, fans, we don't know.
Whoever ends up in the ring, to me, is legal. And there they go.
There they go. You're right. They are quick and fast and great athletes. Wow. Spin wheel kick.
How about that one?
Popped him good. Watch out now. High risk maneuver.
Here he goes.
Coming at you.
Oh, my goodness.
He speared him.
He did. A suicide dive over the top. In the ring, Garza going at it with Psychosis.
Setting him up now, up top. Superplex.
Up and down.
Wow.
And now Juventud's up and down.
Nice teamwork.
And he rolls off.
Wow, somebody else. Got him.
Héctor Garza with the moonsault from behind. Little shove.
Oh.
And Sonny Onoo comes in.
Oh, yeah. Now they're after him now. Juventud, we know, is a mad at Sonny Onoo.
Oh, Dream. He's got a chair again. La Parka's got a chair.
Oh, man.
And he lays out Garza. Lays out Guerrero.
I'm going to tell you what.
Give that man a chair,
yeah,
and then run.
He's run wild on him right here.
And Sonny Onoo's involved here as well.
Oh, this thing is deafening raw right here on Saturday night. Well, as the mothership of TBS is the cooking.
Tomorrow night, there's going to be a six-man Lucha Libre match as part of the big event coming up at Bash of the Beach. But the main event has everyone talking. Dennis Rodman and Hollywood Hulk Hogan together tomorrow night.